गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे कंटिन्यूइंग विद अवर चैप्टर लाइंस एंड एंगल्स, वी विल सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच वी हैव लर्नड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 6.1. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. इन द गिवन फिगर लाइंस ए बी एंड सी डी इंटरसेक्ट एट ओ. इफ एंगल ए ओ सी प्लस एंगल बी ओ ई इक्वल टू 70 डिग्री एंड एंगल बी ओ डी इक्वल टू 40 डिग्री, फाइंड एंगल बी ओ ई एंड रिफ्लेक्स एंगल सी ओ ई. नाउ लुकिंग एट द फिगर वी कैन सी दैट रे ओ सी एंड रे ओ ई स्टैंड्स ऑन लाइन ए बी. सो दिस फॉर्म्स अ लीनियर पेयर, that is we will get these three angles 1 2 and 3 as linear pair. Another thing also is there, that again as ray oe and ray bob stands on line cd, we get again this angle, that is angle eoc plus angle eob plus angle bod equal to 180 degree. That is linear pair axiom. Using this concept, we will find our angles. For solution, ray OE and OC stands on AB. Right now only I explained this. Therefore, angle AOC plus angle COE plus angle BOE equal to 180 degree. Once, let's see in the figure and check it. Yes. OC, this is OC and this is OE. This stands on line AB. So we get three angles, that is angle COA, yeah, you can say AOC plus angle EOC plus angle BOE equal to 180 degree. So we write angle AOC plus angle COE plus angle BOE equal to 180 degree using linear pair axiom. Now we rearrange the angles in such a way because some summation is given in the question itself. So we rearrange it, that is we take angle AOC plus angle BOE together plus angle COE equal to 180 degree. We insert the value of angle AOC plus angle BOE, that is 70 degree, plus angle COE equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle COE equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree, that is equal to 110 degree. Now, reflex angle COE equal to 360 degree minus angle COE. To find reflex angle of any given angle, we subtract the given angle from 360 degree. That is, reflex angle COE equal to 360 degree minus 110 degree equal to 250 degree. Again, also ray OE and OB stands on CD. Therefore, angle COE plus angle BOE plus angle BOD equal to 180 degree. This forms again a linear pair axiom. Let's see in the figure that yes, when ray OE and ray OB stands on line CD, we get angle COE plus angle BOE plus angle BOD equal to 180 degree. Inserting the values of angle COE, we got 110 degree. Angle BOE we have to find out, so we write it as it is. Already angle BOD is given as 40 degree in the question, so we write 40 degree. So we write 110 degree plus angle BOE plus 40 degree equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle BOE plus 150 degree equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle BOE equal to 180 degree minus 150 degree, that is equal to 30 degree. Hence, angle BOE equal to 30 degree. Now, question number 2. In the given figure, lines XY and MN intersect at O. If angle POY equal to 90 degree and A is to B equal to 2 is to 3, find C. Let's see the figure. Now, you can see in the figure that angle XOM, yeah, you can get, go right, MOX is given as B. Angle एम ओ पी इज गिवन एज ए. ऑलरेडी इन क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवन एंगल पी ओ वाई इज गिवन एज 90 degree. दिस इज योर पी ओ वाई 90 degree शोन. एंड एक्स ओ एन दैट इज गिवन एज सी एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ सी. लेट्स प्रोसीड फर्दर फॉर सॉल्यूशन. एज द रेशियो ऑफ ए इज टू बी इज गिवन एज 2:3. सो वी राइट ए इक्वल टू 2x एंड बी इक्वल टू 3x. नाउ रे ओ एम एंड ओ पी स्टैंड्स ऑन एक्स वाई. Therefore, angle XOM plus angle MOP plus angle POY equal to 180 degree. Yes, this is your angle XOM, which is given as B. This is your angle MOP, that is given as B. And angle POY, which is given as 90 degree. This makes a linear pair according to linear pair axiom, as these two rays stand on line XY. So, angle XOM plus angle MOP plus POY equal to 180 degree. Now we insert the values of angles, that is B plus A plus 90 degree equal to 180 degree. That is, again we know that value of B is given as 3x and value of A is given as 2x. So we write 3x plus 2x plus 90 degree equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 5x equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree equal to 90 degree. Therefore, x will be equal to 90 degree divided by 5, that is 18 degree. We have to find the value of a and b, which is given as 2x and 3x. Here we get the value of x. Again, we use the value of x and find the value of a and b. Therefore, now a is angle MOP. Here your angle MOP is A. This is your angle A, that is MOP. So we write angle MOP equal to A equal to 2x equal to 2 into 18 equal to 36 degree. Similarly, we write B is given as angle XOM. So we write angle XOM equal to B equal to 3x equal to 3 into 18 degree 18, that is equal to 54 degree. Now ray OX stands on straight line MN. Therefore, angle MOX plus angle XON equal to 180 degree by linear pair. Now you can see in the figure that OX, this is your ray OX which stands on line MN. Again, these two angles, that is angle MOX, which is given as B, and angle XON will make 180 degree. That is angle MOX plus angle XON equal to 180 degree. Inserting the value of MOX and XON, we get B plus C equal to 180 degree. Ahead only we found out that value of B is 54 degree. So 54 degree plus C equal to 180 degree. So C will be equal to 180 degree minus 54 degree, that is equal to 126 degree. So that is, C is given as angle XON. So we write angle XON equal to C equal to 126 degree. Next question, that is question number 3. In the given figure, angle PQR equal to angle PRQ, then prove that angle PQS equal to PRT. This is a question which we have to prove. So we write given, to prove, and proof separately, where you have to find the angles, measurement of the angles, then you don't need to write given and prove. But wherever you have to question, prove the question, we write given and to prove with proof. So first, it is given in the question that angle PQR equal to angle PRQ. These two angles, PQR equal to PRQ, these two angles are given as equal. Now we have to prove that angle PQS equal to PRT, that is, these two angles we have to prove, PQS equal to PRT. This we have to prove. Now for proof, RAQP stands on line SQT. Now you can see in the figure that this is RAQP. We take as line, you can write as ST also, no deal, we are taking SQT, this line. So two angles, we can see the formation of two angles. This is angle 1 and this is angle 2. Two angles are formed which makes 180 degree, that is angle PQS plus angle PQR equal to 180 degree. Again I will show you, this is angle PQS and this is angle PQR. These two angles make 180 degree by linear pair axiom. So we write it as number 1. Again we know another ray also stands on line ST, you can write, or SRT also, it's okay. So we take another line now, RP stands on line SRT. Again we can see two angles are forming a straight line, that is making 180 degree by linear pair axiom. So we write angle PRQ plus angle PRT equal to 180 degree. This is your angle PRQ and this is your angle PRT, which on summation gives 180 degree by linear pair axiom. Give it number 2. Now from 1 and 2 we get angle PQS plus angle PQR equal to angle PRQ plus angle PRT. S both right hand side are equal, we compare it left hand side with the left hand side. So we write angle PQS plus angle PQR of number 1 left hand side equal to angle PRQ plus angle PRT left hand side of number 2. Further solving, we get angle PQS equal to PRT. Why we get like this? Because already in the question you can see above, it is given that angle PQR and angle PRQ are equal. So both side equals are cut. So we get angle PQS equal to angle PRT. Hence proved, it is necessary to write in the questions where we have to prove at the last of the solution. Next question. That is question number 4. Again an interesting question. In the given figure, if x plus y equal to w plus z, then prove that AOB is a line. Now looking at the figure, you can see that it is given that these two angles, x plus y, this is equal to w plus z. When we add these two angles, this is equal to these two angles. In the figure itself we can see when angle x plus y is added, it makes 180 degree. Similarly when w plus z is added, it makes 180 degree because they both are adjacent, both pairs are adjacent angles which stands on line AB. For solution, let's see. From the given figure, the complete angle formed at O is x plus y plus w plus z equal to 360 degree. You know that complete angle is always 360 degree, that is this is whole complete angle 360 degree. So we write x plus y plus w plus z equal to 360 degree. Now we know that it is given in the question that x plus y equal to w plus z is given. We use this, so from 1 we get, yeah, we obtain x plus y, we write as it is x plus y, and in place of w plus z we write again x plus y because w plus z is nothing but x plus y. So we write x plus y equal to 360 degree, that is 2 times x plus y equal to 360 degree, that is x plus y equal to 180 degree. But you know, these are the adjacent angles formed by ray OC standing on AB. You can see that these two angles, that is x plus y, these two angles are formed when ray OC stands on AB. These two are adjacent angles which are made when ray OC stands on AB. Thus, from linear pair axiom, if sum of the two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the non-common arms of the angle form a line. This is already given in a axiom. Therefore, AOB is a line, hence proved. Next question, that is question number 5. In the given figure, POQ is a line. Ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. OS is another ray lying between rays OP and OR. Prove that angle ROS equal to half angle QOS minus angle POS. Let's see the figure. According to the question, it is given that OR is perpendicular to OP. So these two angles, this is one angle and this is another angle, these both will be 90 degree. Perpendicular means angles is 90 degree. So these two angles will be 90 degree. Further, it is also given in the question that ray OS bisects, OS is another ray other than OR standing on PQ. Using this, let's find the solution. Now for solution, ray OR is perpendicular to line POQ. So, angle POR equal to 90 degree and angle QOR equal to 90 degree. I already explained this, that as OR is perpendicular to PQ, your angle POR, this will be also 90 degree, and already this is given as 90 degree. Perpendicular means 90 degree only. Again, from the figure we have angle QOS equal to angle QOR plus angle OROS. Now first let's see angle QOS. This is whole angle QOS. This is formed by the summation of two angles, that is angle QOR. This is your angle QOR and another angle ROS. So we write angle QOS equal to angle QOR plus angle ROS and give it as number 1. Again, we have another angle in similar way, that is angle POR. Now you can see this is angle POR. Again, this is the summation of angle POS and angle ROS. So we write angle POR equal to angle POS plus angle ROS and give it as number 2. Now adding 1 and 2, we get, when we are adding the equations, left hand side is added with left hand side and right hand side is added with right hand side. So we write angle QOS plus angle POR equal to angle QOR plus angle ROS plus angle POS plus angle ROS. Further solving, we get angle QOS plus 90 degree. Above you can see the value of angle POR is 90 degree equal to angle QOR. Again its value is 90 degree. So we write 90 degree plus angle POS plus 2 times angle ROS. Here the value of angle POR is taken as 90 degree. Again value of QOR is taken as 90 degree. Again this ROS plus ROS will give 2 times ROS. So we write angle QOS plus 90 degree equal to 90 degree plus angle POS plus 2 twice angle ROS. Now left hand side and right hand side both having 90 degree will be cut, and we solve further, that is angle QOS equal to angle POS plus twice ROS. Further solving, we get 2 times angle ROS, yeah, twice angle ROS equal to angle QOS minus angle POS. We transpose angle POS on left left hand side, so plus will become minus. Further solving, we get angle ROS equal to half angle QS minus angle ROS, minus angle POS, which we require to prove. So we prove that angle ROS equal to half angle QOS minus angle POS. Hence, proved. In the last question of the exercise, it is given that angle XYZ equal to 64 degrees and XY is produced to point P. Draw a figure from the given information. If ray YQ bisects angle ZYP, find angle XYQ and reflects angle QYP. Now for the solution, first we draw the figure. Now the required figure is shown as below. Already it is given that angle XYZ is given as 64 degrees in the question. This is given as 64 degrees. Already in the question it was asked further that you have to produce your XY to point P, which we have produced here as 2 point P. Again it is further given that YQ is the bisector of angle ZYP. This is given in the question. According to question, we have drawn the figure. Now let's find the solution further. Now to find the solution, ray YZ stands on line PYX. You can see in the figure that ray YZ, this is your ray YZ, which stands on line PYZ. When this stands on line, you get angle XYZ plus angle ZYP equal to 180 degrees using linear pair axiom. That is, angle XYZ is given as 64 degrees and angle ZYP equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, we insert the value 64 degrees plus angle ZYP equal to 180 degrees. That is, angle ZYP equal to 180 degrees minus 64 degrees equal to 116 degrees. This is number, let it be number 1. Further, now further it is also there that ray YQ bisects angle ZYP. Bisect the angle means it divides the given angle into two equal angles. Therefore, angle QYP will be equal to half of angle ZYP. Let's see in the figure this. Yes, let's see in the figure angle XYQ. This is your angle XYQ. This is the summation of two angles, that is XYZ and angle ZYQ. When we add these two angles, we get the whole angle XYZ. Now we insert the values, that is angle XYQ equal to 64 degrees, because already angle XYZ is given as 64 degrees in question, plus angle ZYQ, which we have already found ahead, that is 58 degrees. So we write angle XYQ is equal to 64 degrees plus 58 degrees. Therefore, angle XYQ equal to 122 degrees. Thank you very much.